in the past I've shot on a few things. I shot on the EX1, which is a little brother of this one, in Israel, and then I've shot on Z1, Panasonic P2. But this is the Sony EX3. This is probably the largest camera I've traveled with, because I find that, you know, you're always going to carry on your camera. You don't want to store it away because you don't know what's going to happen to it. You don't know if it's going to turn up at the other end. It's a solid state. So they hold, the 16 gig card holds about an hour's worth on there of high definition. So we took away 5 cards. So we had plenty of space to deal with when we were out in the field. Matt, the producer, is a soundie as well, and he's got a Roland Eddie Roll. So it's a mixer recorder, solid state recorder. But our basic setup was with a wireless system, a Sennheiser wireless system. I was completely hooked up with him the whole time, and he had the Sennheiser ME66 boom mic operating, so I was getting his feed through that, as well as I was just using the internal mic as a backup. But we didn't have any problems with our connection there, and on this shoot it was nice to be completely wireless from the sound guy. The EX3 has a shoulder mount, little pull out rest there, that's quite handy, and you can also adjust the viewfinder to sit where you want it to sit. So generally, that's the kind of the setup that I'd use. And at one point we were shooting on the back of a motorbike. I had a sidecar and we shot a sequence of the children riding their bikes to school. So we were able to get right alongside them, in front of them, behind them, and jump up ahead and get some good shots. So it was all very quick guerrilla style filmmaking. This camera's quite versatile and you can get around. It only weighs about 7 kilos. So, you know, like some of your other shoulder mount cameras with similar lenses, they're a lot heavier. So I think in that kind of setup, it was nice to have something a bit lighter.
Cutting on Final Cut?
Yep, cutting on Final Cut. We shot in 1080i format.
Are you gonna have to buy heaps of externals because you're tapeless?
Yeah, I've actually bought a few hard drives since I acquired this camera, so it does chew up a fair bit. But hard drives are quite cheap these days. We're double backing up. You can't trust a hard drive, but everything's double backed up, so you shouldn't have a problem of losing footage from trips.
Which has happened before.
I'd rather not talk about that.
Cool.